first act today is someone who has come all the way from California in America. He describes himself as a DIY indie rock artist, and he is an instrumentalist only, so no vocals, but he is very, very good. Could we please give a big round of applause to South to Madrid.
South to Madrid, which it's not a big story that how I got that name. Basically, I was on a freeway in New Mexico going to an IB conference, and there was a sign that said South to Madrid. There's a city named Madrid in New Mexico. I'm like, oh, that kind of has a nice ring to it, and that became the name of this project that I've been doing now for about 12 or 13 years. So, as you said, I'm a multi-instrumentalist, and so the songs that you would hear in my SoundCloud are all instrumental. I only sing cover songs on occasion, but I don't write lyrics and sing on my original songs. So that hopefully you'll find these songs interesting that I'm gonna play tonight. So this first song is a song that's on that on my SoundCloud album. It's called Somehow, Sometime, which I tend to be an optimistic person, and so this has kind of an optimistic ring to it that, you know, at some point in the future we'll get what we're hoping we will get. Thank you. kind of an old song for me. None of you ever heard it, so it'll be new for you. But actually, I wrote this, gosh, probably like 20 years ago now, but I still love playing this song, and I do play it. I'm under South Madrid, so it's called Closer to Ghosting. I can't remember why I named it that, because it's so old, but I hope you like it. Baby and just kind of work it out and finally worked out the whole song, you know, I forget when, but finally finished it. It was kind of nameless for a while, but I decided to call it Boo, B-O-O, for two reasons. One is that when I gave her first teddy bear, I was trying to get her to name it. She was only 4 months old, so she wasn't speaking, but kind of the first thing that she verbalized that I could recognize was Boo, so that's what we called her bear. Calling her bear, Boo Boo Bear. So I thought this was the first song I wrote after she was born, so that kind of fit. But it also kind of has a deeper meaning, I think, because you know, becoming a single parent or just life in general, things just kind of creep up on you in life and go boo. You're not expecting it. So this title has that meaning to it as well. So this is actually a finger pointing song. So. Thank you. originally a drummer in my musical life. And then at the, I started playing guitar at the age of 17, which was 30 years ago now. But a couple years before that, I heard a band about 1984, 1985 that just totally blew my mind. And that's really what made me want to play guitar, because the guitarist for that band was doing things that I'd never heard before, and just phenomenal. I said, I want to write songs and be innovative like the way this guitarist plays. And that band is called The Smiths, and the guitarist is Johnny Marr. Does anybody know The Smiths? Yes. So there's a couple different things that he does in his songs that kind of wasn't happening in the 80s or kind of prior to that. And I'm just going to play a few little Smiths riffs here to kind of demonstrate some of those. So one of them is the way that he would take like major 9, major 7, minor 7th, and those kind of jazzy chords and clash them with regular major chords to create a new sound. And one of them that he did that brilliantly in is a song called The Headmaster Ritual, which is off of Meet His Murder album. And then another song where he did take a lot of jazzy chords, and when he wrote it, if you see interviews with him when he talks about this, he didn't know if it was actually going to be a Smith song, because it's very different than what the Smiths were actually doing. But it ended up becoming one of their most loved songs, and that's a song called Heaven Knows I'm Miserable Now. His picking through open voice chords and regular open chords down. That's kind of his signature style, is that jingle jangle. But one of the songs that always struck me with his ability to choose chords and pick through them was a song called Some Girls Are Bigger Than Others, which is the last song off their seminal album called The Queen Is Dead. Sometimes with another Smith song, which is actually a John Peel session that was on the Half of a Hallow album, I don't know if you know that album, and it's a song called Back to the Old House. Thank you. one of the newest songs that I've written. It actually doesn't have a title, so there's really not a story behind it, other than it's just a riff that I just was kind of working on over a period of time, and it's a complete song now, so hope you like it. This is my last song. This is actually the first song on my album that is on SoundCloud, and it's called Awake. Literally, I was living in Beijing, and I just woke up in the middle of the night, couldn't sleep, grabbed my guitar, and just started writing this riff, and that's why I called it Awake. But I guess it could have like a deeper kind of Buddhist spiritual meaning, like awakening, nirvana sort of thing, if you want to think of it that way. But thank you all for listening, and I'm Thomas, and this is South to Madrid. Yeah.